trying to avoid a gift fail? Lifestyle expert Janette Ewen joins us this morning with Santa's picks and pans for giving. But as long as you're giving, it's the thought, right?
It's so about thoughtfulness. So I'm actually going to start with a pan of unthoughtfulness. So a very good girlfriend of mine, this is the funniest story. She once received two pairs of socks from a six-pack of socks, and they were wrapped, and the gentleman asked for the wrapping back when the socks had been opened. And she suspected that those other four pairs of socks might be going to other ladies. So,
were they?
They were.
Now, good spidey senses there.
Had that gentleman perhaps taken the same pair of socks, added in one with a little bit of personality, I always say slap a bow and it's good to go, maybe tucked in the candy and a name tag, she would have never suspected.
But maybe that was a good life lesson for her to learn. Yeah, beware of the socks.
A good life lesson, and I'll tell you a good laugh for us. So speaking of thoughtfulness, now let's move over to how you can be thoughtful. With everything going on, we'll be having a lot of virtual holidays this year, a lot of virtual gatherings. And a group of people I really like to think about this time of year is people who are, say, over the age of 60, because 50% of Canadians over that age suffer from hearing loss. So when you're doing these virtual gatherings, it can be really challenging for them. So there's a few things we can do to make it easier. For example, have great lighting, because lip reading is actually a part of how we all hear. Mm-hmm. So they want to be able to see that. They want to be able to see your expressions. Remind the kids, even though they're excited to see grandma and grandpa, to give them a chance to speak and give them a chance to listen. Also, you can go to hearinglife.ca, and I'm going to have some information up on my Instagram, a swipe up of just little things that you can do to make the hearing easier during the virtual parties. And there's also great things you can get for them, gifts. I love this alarm clock. It's kind of like a shake awake situation. It's got 120 decibel sound, which you can adjust. And then this little shaker goes under your pillow to wake you up. I actually think this is so great. And again, it's hearinglights.ca. And I should mention that they do have free professional hearing tests as well.
Good stuff.
All right, so should we give a little gift of me time? So when you are giving me time, say you're giving mom a spa day at home or a relaxing hour, actually give them the me time. The pan time would be the constant knocking on the door, or are you enjoying this? Are you relaxing, mom? Instead, just let her chill out. And the same goes for dad when you give him the gift of me time. I also recommend pairing it with a great cocktail or just a great whiskey. This is Talisker. It's from the oldest distillery on the Isle of Skye. It's a 10-year-old most awarded single malt scotch, and it's kind of got this by the sea adventure vibe. It can really help you warm up at home during the holidays, whether you have it neat or on ice, and that's a really beautiful, beautiful gift item as well. Okay, a gift of passion. The pan would be, don't force your passion on others. I once dated a fellow for a few years, and every year I would receive a giant angel sculpture from his mom. So thoughtful, yes, but it's what she actually collected, not my passion. So a great gift of passion is the gift of passion for the person who loves coffee, and a beautiful, beautiful coffee maker. I love this. This is the Philips Latte Go, the Philips 3200 Latte Go. It makes five styles of coffee drinks. This is actually my personal coffee maker. I can't recommend this one enough. It's a great value. You can get some coffees from a local roaster to give with it. And it's just something that they'll love ongoing. And, you know, wake up every morning and think of you when they use this one. Okay, let's talk a tiny, tiny bit about giving back this time of year. And I think you'll like this one and that.
This
is the idea of giving back to pets. And this is a Santa's pick because it's like a double duty give back. So I partner with PetSmart Charities of Canada, and every year they do their philanthropic collection, and they've got Lucky. We've met Chance before. We're going to keep Lucky the cat up there because I know you like cats, but they have also an alpaca this year.
Oh,
his
cute.
His name is Bliss. I know, so cute. And why I love these is if you go to PetSmart.ca, you can purchase them as they're $5. So great, an affordable gift. 10% of profits goes back to PetSmart Charities of Canada, which helps partner pets and humans across the country, which goes to local shelters. And they also suggest that you donate these to a toy drive or a senior citizens drive. So I thought that was so nice.
That is really, really nice.
On the holiday, they can cuddle their
okay.
pet.
Okay. Do you know what, Janette? We have run out of time.
Are we all done?
Yes.
Okay.
That's a fail.
Good.
That's a fail. So,
no,
Merry Christmas to you.
That's mine. Merry Christmas.